of people lined the streets of downtown Lubbock to watch the South Plains Fair Parade. Randy Escamilla shows us what a band goes through to prepare for the parade.
Like the other 28 bands in today's parade, the Denver City Mustangs got up early and drove to Lubbock. Being the two-time state marching band champions carries a lot of responsibilities and pride.
It's kind of like a football team, really. That's how we run it, really.
You feel like a coach?
Sort of. They call me coach sometimes. They slip up and say that, yes.
As other teams began marching in the parade, they knew it was almost their time to line everyone up, polish instruments, and tape helmets.
Great.
As they got in the parade, one of the band's biggest problems was turning corners, but they all managed okay. There was a time in the parade when bands would stop and play for the judges. This allowed the Denver City band to scout the others' performance. The excitement peaked as they played before the judges, and yes, the judges saw them, and the crowd showed its support. When it was over, there was relief and cheer, and one thing says it all.
That's about what it was like. It was tiring, but it was worth it. We don't know the results yet, but I pray that we win, and everybody here prays that we win, because we worked so hard, and we really want it. Bad. Real bad.
If bad means good, they were bad, because this band not only won first place in its division, but left the parade as the best overall band. Randy Escamilla, News 11.
Mustang fever is high in Denver City these days, all because of the red-hot marching band, destined for a shot at state title number 3. A lot of hard work has paid off under the direction of David Rollins and David Riker.
Some of you guys get lazy over here.
That's what we teach here. A hard work will get the job done.
But the band has more to look forward to than state competition. The Mustangs have been invited to appear in the nationally televised Hollywood Parade of Stars the Sunday after Thanksgiving. A Los Angeles production crew spent 2 days shooting a feature segment. Producer Joel Tater.
Next to the Rose Parade, it's probably the biggest parade in the country.
Tater says Denver City captures the flavor of a small town, perfect for this Hollywood production. For Riker and the band, it's the opportunity of a lifetime.
There's supposed to be 1.5 million people there, and we've never played to that many people.
The Denver City High School Marching Band has much to look forward to. A little Hollywood on the national level, plus the hope of a third straight victory on the state level. Now all they have to do is write their own storybook ending.
The kids are ready for it. They have never let down at all. It seems like, you see, 3 in a row, maybe that's 3's a charm.
In Denver City, I'm Carla Leslie for News 11.
Is your bat ready? high school.
All right, Leno!
Fourth place, Robinson High School.
Thank you.
City Mustang Marching Band is led on the field this afternoon by drum major Kenneth Major. The band will be playing an exciting opener by Ricardo Strauss. Be playing a Spanish medley of Cordova, Corona, and Topaz. And then from the strings of the green, as big as the West, they will conclude with the theme from the John Wayne movie, The Cowboys.
Take the field for a competition.
Denver City, Texas.